Hello students, good morning. How are you students? I hope your unit is fine. Today we are going to see about properties of addition. So far in the unit 1 number system, we are dealing with the chapter 1 integers. In the integer we have seen all the four operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisions, all the four fundamental operations we have seen children. Next what we are going to see is properties of each operation. At first we are going to see about properties of addition. In the properties of addition, first we are going to see about the five properties. What are they are? First one is, you can easily remember by using this four way children. That is CCAI grade. C stands for closure property, and this C for commutative, and this A for associative, and this I for identity, and this I for inverse. These are the five properties. Now we are going to see for the operation addition. See here, first one, closure property. What is the main closure property? One more information children, these are the your basic foundation for your higher studies. Whenever you move to the higher class, these properties definitely will come children. So listen the class carefully, okay? First we are going to see about closure property. How can you understand the closure property for the addition is by seeing this example, you can easily understand. See this example. First example, 20 plus 13. As per the rule 1, if the given integer are in same sign, means you have to add the integer. So 20 plus 30 answer is 50. See here, we are taking two integer and we are adding, the result is also an integer. Take next example, 56 plus minus 53. As per the rule 2, the given integer are in different sign, means you have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. So 56 minus 53 answer is 3, and the result takes the symbol of the larger number. So the 3 takes the symbol of 56 plus. Thus we are taking two integers, one is positive integer, one is negative integer, and we apply the operation addition and we get the result, it is also an integer. See the next example, minus 25 and minus 35. Here the operation is addition. As per the rule 1, if the given two integers are in same sign, means we have to add the two integers. So 25 plus 5 plus we get 30, 30 plus 30, 60, and the result takes the common sign, that is minus. Thus, we are taking two negative integers, the result is a negative integer. Here we are taking two positive integers, the result is a positive integer. Thus, in any case, if you are taking two integers and we apply the operation addition, we get the result as an integer only. Thus, we say that integer is closed under addition. How can we give the definition for this closure property? See here children, this is very important. If a and b are any integers, we have to write here. If a and b are any integers, then a plus b is also an integer. We are taking two integers a and b. We get a plus b is also an integer, means we can say integer are closed under addition. Whenever you write the property, name of the property, you have to mention the operation. Here you have to write the operation. What is it? Addition. Thus, if you take any two integers a and b, then a plus b is also an integer. Then we can say integers are closed under addition. Thus, we are seeing this example. We are taking two integers. Instead of a and b, we are taking two integers and we get a plus b. What is the a plus b answer? 50. It is also an integer. Thus, the addition operation satisfied the closure property. What is the next property we are going to see is commutative property. It is very, very important property. What is commutative property? See this example. First 12 plus 15. What is the answer? As per the rule 1, you have to add this 27. Next, here we add the 12 with 15. Next year we are adding 15 with 12, but the answer is remains same only, 27 only. Next we take different integers, that is one is positive, one is negative. What happened we see? 35 plus minus 20. As per the rule 2, given two integers are in different sign, means we have to subtract the smaller integer from the larger one. So 35 minus 20, you get 15. The 15 gets the symbol of the larger number. So the 15 gets plus. So next we are going to add minus 20 with 35. What happens is minus 20 plus 35. As per the rule 2, you have to separate the small integer from the larger number. So here also you get the same answer, 15 only. Thus, if you change the order of the addition, if you change the order of the addition integers, the result is not changing. That is, the result remains same. Here also you get 12 plus 15 also 27. 15 plus 12 also 27. Similarly, 35 plus minus 20 is also 15. Minus 20 plus 35 is also 15. See the next example. Minus 10 plus minus 15. So the integers are in same sign. You can add. So the result is minus 28. Next we are going to add minus 18 with minus 10. That is minus 18 plus minus 10. As per the rule 2, the given integers are of same sign. So you have to add the two integers to get the answer minus 28. Thus, if you change the order of the addition, that is, you are changing the numbers, but it does not affect the result of the addition of integers. This type of property is called commutative property. I can give you a real life example to you children. If you add sugar with milk or milk with sugar, what happens? The sugar will dissolve. Like this, if you add 12 with 15 or 15 with 12, the answer remains same. This type of property is called commutative property. We can give the definition for this as like this. If A and B are any two integers, then A plus B is equal to change the order. B plus A, this type of property is called commutative property. Thus, we can say integers are commutative under the operation addition. Thus, we have seen the two properties of addition. One is closure property and next one is commutative property. Next, we are going to see is associative property. It is also a very important property. Associative means you have to take more than two elements. That's why we are taking three elements. Whenever you are writing the associative property, definitely you have to take three elements. Okay. See the example. Minus 12 plus 8 plus minus 5. Here we are taking three integers. Now we are going to add the three integers. See the first here. Here, first we are adding the second integer with third integer first. So write the first integer as it is. Minus 12 plus 8 plus, now we are going to remove the bracket of minus 5. Plus into minus minus, write the 5 as it is. 8 minus 5. What is the answer for 8 minus 5? 3. Thus minus 12 plus 9. Thus the integer are in different sign. So you have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. Thus 9, and the result get the symbol of the larger number, then minus 9. In the process of addition of three integers, first we are adding the second integer. This is the first integer, second integer, third integer. We are adding the second integer and third integer first. After the get the result, we are adding the result with the first integer. We get the answer as minus 9. See here children. Here we change the order of addition here. Here, first we are adding the minus 12 and 8 here. In this example, we are adding the second integer and the third integer first. But here, we are adding the first integer and the second integer. What will the answer example? Let us see. Minus 8 plus 8 plus minus 5. First, we are going to add the first integer and the second integer. According to the rule 2, we get minus 1 minus 12 plus 8 is equal to minus 4 plus, write the minus 5 as it is, okay? Minus 4 plus into minus minus 5. Given two integers are in same sign. Therefore, as per the rule 1, you get the answer minus 9 plus. See, these two are the same example. Here we add the second integer and the third integer first, and then we add the result with the first integer, you get the answer minus 9. Here, you add the first integer and the second integer first, and you add the result with the third integer. Here also you get the answer, the same answer minus 9. So what we have observed from this example is, in the process of addition, we can use the any order of addition. Okay. in the nominative property we have interchanged the elements. Here first you are adding the second and the third first, and here we are adding the first and the second first. Why we are seeing this type of property is while doing the sums, you have the doubt, or shall we do the sum like this method? Some other students will do the sum this method. So you have the confused which method is right. Both methods are right by the associative property of addition. That's why we are having such properties. Okay. See the next one. 5 + -3 + 2. First we are adding the second integer with third integer. As per the rule 2, you get -1. So add -1 with the first integer, you get 4. See here, first we are going to add first integer and then second integer. 5 + -5 -3, you get 2. And the third integer is 2. 2 + 2 = 4. Thus, we are taking the 3 integer. At first we are adding the second and the third, and then the answer, and then you get one answer. You are adding the answer with the first integer, you get 4. Similarly here, you are adding the first 2 integer and you get one answer. You are adding the answer with third integer, you get one answer, but both remains same. From this example, what we have concluded is, if you are taking any 3 integers A, B, C, if you are adding A plus B plus C, which is equal to A plus B plus C. You have to read this definition as A plus. You have to give one short pause here. A plus B plus C. You have to read it as whole, which is equal to A plus B. You have to give the short pause now. Plus C. This type of property is called associative property of addition. It's clear, children? Children, we have 5 properties for the addition operation. What are the 5 properties? Closure, commutative, associative, identity, inverse. These are the 5 properties. Among these 5, we have seen 3 properties. Okay, next we are going to see identity. What is meant identity? Let us see this example. 7 + 0 = 7. 0 + 9 = 9. -8 + 0, what is the answer? -8. 0 + -4, it is also the -4. Thus, if you add any number with 0, 0 means any number. Whether the number is positive or negative, it doesn't matter. If you add any number with 0, 0 means any number, the answer is the same number. Okay. Can you observe this from this example? 7 + 0 = 7, 0 + 9 = 9, -8 + 0 = -8. 0 + -4 = -4. From this example, we can observe, if we add any number with 0 or 0 with any number, we get the same number. This type of property is called additive identity property. Why we are using the term additive is, here the operation we are using is addition. Thus, we are getting additive identity. Thus, 0 is called the additive identity for the integers under the operation addition. See the definition. If A is any integer, then how can you write the additive identity property like this? 0 plus A. This is the number 0. Okay. 0 plus A is equal to A plus 0 equal to A. That is, if you add 0 with A or A with 0, the result is A only. Here A means you have to take any integer. Okay. Next we are going to see additive inverse. What is additive inverse? See this example. 1 + -1. Remove the symbol, remove the bracket, children. 1 + -1. That is 1 - 1. What is the answer? 0. Similarly, 4 - 4. What is the answer? 0. -15 + 15. What is the answer? 0. Thus, we are taking two numbers. We are taking two numbers. One is positive and one is negative. And we are adding that. We get one result. The result is 0. What is 0 here? 0 is the additive identity. Thus, if there are two numbers such that when they are added, the result is additive identity. The result should be additive identity means, then each number is called additive inverse of each other, or each additive inverse of the other. Okay. How we are calling 1 as? 1 is the additive inverse of -1. Why you are calling 1 as additive inverse of -1 means, if you add 1 with -1, the answer is 0. The 0 is nothing but additive identity. Thus, we are calling one as additive inverse of minus one. We also call as minus one as additive inverse of one. Similarly, 4 is called as additive inverse of minus 4. Minus 4 is called as additive inverse of 4. Explain, children. What is the definition for additive inverse? Here, a plus minus a. That is one positive integer and negative of that integer. If you add the two integer, you get the answer 0. But this also can be write as minus a plus a, which is also equal to 0 only. That's all about the additive inverse. So far, children, we are seeing all the five properties of addition. First one is closure, and then commutative, next associative, and then identity, and the last inverse. These five properties are very, very important, children. Next, we are going to see example one. This example one is based on the properties of addition. What is example one? Fill in the blanks and state the property used. That is, you are going to fill in the blanks, and you also have to state what is the property you are going to use. Which property you are going to use to fill the blanks? Okay. See the first one. If x and y are any two integers, what they are given is x and y are any two integers, then x plus y is also an dash. What they are asking? They are taking x and y to integer. What they are asking? X plus y is also an dash. If x and y are integer means, then x plus y is also an, what is the answer, children? Yes, is also an integer. So what is the property we are using here? Yes, closure and the addition. What is the property we are using here? Closure property. The closure property, we said if a and b are any integer, then a plus b is also an integer. Okay. See the next one. Minus 946 plus minus 209, which is equal to dash plus minus 946. You have seen such examples in your lower classes, but here you are having the negative integer and the positive integer. What is the answer coming to the blank, children? Here, minus 946 plus minus 209, which is equal to dash plus minus 946. What is the answer from here? Yes, minus 209. Here you are writing this number as first, but here you are writing the second integer as the first. Thus, you are interchanging the order of addition. How can you name this property, children? Closure, commutative, associative, identity, inverse. You know, five properties. Among these five properties, which property you are used here? Yes, commutative property. Here we are using the commutative property. The commutative property means definitely you have only two elements. Associative means definitely you have three elements. You can use this thing to remember the property. Okay. Thus you have the two elements. Thus you are changing the order of the integers. Addition of the integers. Thus, the property name is commutative property. See the next one. 65 plus 15 plus 56, which is equal to dash plus 15 plus 56. Here, they are adding the 65 plus 15 first. They are adding the first two integer first. And here, they are adding the second and the third integer first. So, it's clearly the which property? Yes, associative property. So, what is the answer from here? The first integer. What is the first integer? 65. Thus, we are writing the property used is associative property. See the next one. 451 plus 0 is equal to dash plus 451. So, the answer is? Yes, 0. So, 0 plus 451 is equal to 451 only. If you add any number with 0 or 0 with any number, the answer should be the same. This type of property is called additive identity. So, you have to write here property used equal to additive identity. See here, 0 plus minus 8 is equal to minus 8 plus dash, the same property. So, what is the number from here? Yes, 0. Thus, what is the property used here? Additive identity. See the next one. 23 plus dash equal to dash plus 23 equal to 0. That is, you are adding some number with 23 and also you are adding the same number with 23. You get the answer is 0. What is the answer? See this example. If you are adding 1 with minus 1 or minus 4 with 4 or minus 5 15 with 5 15, you get the answer is 0. That is one positive number and negative of that number, the result will get 0. This Jacob property is called inverse. So 23 plus, what is the answer should come children? 23 plus, yes, 23 plus minus 23. Similarly, minus 23 plus 23, which is equal to 0. What is the property used here? Additive, identity. So far, we are discussing all the 5 properties of addition, children. We are going to see example 2, children. What is example 2? Pooja receives rupees 50 from her aunt. Pooja gives rupees 40 to Seema. Venu returns rupees 30 that she owed to Pooja. Also, Pooja buys a pen for rupees 10 from the stationery shop. How much money does Pooja have at the end of the day? What is giving the question is, Pooja is receiving some amount from his hand and also she gives some amount to Seema. Venu also gives some amount to Pooja and Pooja buys a pen. At the end of the day, what is the amount of Pooja? This is the question, children. Without doing the calculation, let us do this sum practically. Okay? See, children, the amount is very small. Okay, what is the amount? Rupees 50. So, Pooja have the amount 50. That is 20 plus 20, 40 plus 50. This is the amount Pooja has first. Okay? After that, what she did? She used rupees 40 to Seema. After receiving the 50 rupees from her aunt, she returns, she gives 40 rupees to Seema. So from this amount 50 rupees, she takes 20 plus 20, 40 rupees, she gives to Seema. Okay. Now, what the amount will have the Pooja now? Only the 10 rupees. Among the 40, 50 rupees, she gives 40 to Seema. So now she has only 10 rupees. Then, Venu returns rupees 30 to Pooja that she have to give. Now, the Venu came and gave 30 rupees to Pooja. That is 20 plus 10. That is 30 rupees to Pooja. Already Pooja have 10 rupees with her. So, 10 plus 30. What is the amount now the Pooja have? 20, 30, 40. Okay? See the children. First, Pooja have 50 rupees. After that, Pooja give 40 rupees to Seema and then Venu returns 30 rupees to Pooja. Now, the Pooja have 40 rupees with her. What the Pooja did next? Pooja buys a pen for rupees 10 from the stationery shop. Pooja went to a stationery shop and she buy a pen for rupees 10. So, she give the 10 rupees to the shop owner and she bought the pen. So, at last, what is the Pooja have with the money? She have only 20 plus 10, she have 30 rupees with her only. Thus, without doing the calculation, by using the amount, we have found at the end of the day, she have 30 rupees with her. Now, we are going to use the steps. The amount is very small, that way we are using the amount. If the amount given is crore, lakh, means how can you do the sum? Let us see the solution for this sum. What is first we are writing the steps. What are the steps? Amount Pooja received from her hand. What is the amount Pooja received from her hand? Rupees 50. So you are writing rupees 50 here. And Pooja gives to Seema. What is the amount Pooja gives to Seema? Rupees 40. And what is the amount Pooja received from Venu? Rupees 30. And what is the amount spent for pen by Pooja? Is rupees 10. These are the details given in the question. This is the in this sum, the amount is small. That's why we see the sum practically. Suppose if the sum involves in lakh and crores means we can't do this practically. Okay. So what is the amount Pooja have at the end of the day? How we are going to find the amount that Pooja have at the end of the day? See here, children. At first, the Pooja have rupees 50 and then she gives. She gives means you have to use the symbol negative. That is, the amount she is not having. So you have to use the symbol minus. If you are having the amount means you have to use the symbol plus here. You know that here the symbol is plus here. Okay. That is plus rupees 50 and she used the amount 40. Okay, 42 CMOL. That's why you see the symbol minus, minus 40. And Venu returns to Pooja. That is, she has having that money to be studied. So you have to use the symbol plus. If you are giving means, that is, if you are giving for not having that money means, you have to use the symbol negative. If you are having, if you are receiving means, you have to simple, you have to use the symbol plus. Then you are using the symbol plus 30. And she spent. She is spent. That is, she is not having that money. Then you are using the symbol minus. She is spent rupees 10 for buying a pen. So you are using the symbol like this. Why you are using the symbol minus for 40 and minus for 10 rupees? She is spent 10 for pen and she returns the amount 42 CMA. That is, she is not having. So you have to use the symbol minus for both the integer. It's clear to them. Next, you can do this summing two ways. What are the two ways? First way is, you can subtract the 40 from 50. What is the answer you get? 10. If you subtract 40 from 50, you get 10. And 10 from 30, what do you get? 20. So, 10 plus 20, the answer is 30. What is the another method? Another method is, you can add the integer which have the same symbol. What are the integers having the same symbol? 50 and 30. Both are having the same symbol plus. So you are adding 50 plus 30. What is the answer you got? 80. And what is the next integer having the same symbol? 40 and 10. So what is the answer you get? Minus 50. Plus 50 plus 30 plus 80. Minus 40 minus 10. The answer is minus 50. So as per the rule to subtract the value from the large number, that is 80 minus 50. The answer is plus 30. I hope you understand this some children. It's clear, children. Next we are going to see the exercise problem. Exercise 1.1 first sum. A division. If x and y are two integers, then write the commutative property of addition for x and y. Okay? What they are asking? They give x and y two integers and they are asking to write the commutative property of addition. Before answering the question, you have to observe the question and what are the operation they give. What is the operation here they give? Addition. Suppose if they give multiplication means, you have to use the multiple symbol for the commutative property. You know the commutative property. For the commutative property, you have to use two numbers. I give the real example, that is milk with sugar. You can remember that, children. That is, what is the commutative property? A plus B is equal to B plus A. Now we are posting for each other. How can you do the commutative property for multiplication? Yes, A into B equal to B into A. How can you do the commutative property for subtraction? A minus B is equal to B minus A. Like that, we can define the commutative property for different operation. Okay, what is given in the question is, x and y are two integers. They are asking us to write the commutative property for the two integers. We know that commutative property, A plus B equal to B plus A. Instead of using A and B, we are now going to use the integer x and y. That is, x plus y is equal to y plus x. That's all the answer to the next. Verify the commutative property of addition of the integers 44 and minus 35. That is, they given two integers 44 and minus 35. What they are asking is, we have to verify. That is, commutative property of addition is holds good or not. That is, you have to find the answer. That is, x plus y. You get one answer. But also, you have to find the y plus x. Both the answers come same or not. That's we are going to verify now. Okay. What are the two integers 44 and minus 35? First, you have to write the commutative property of addition. What is the commutative property of addition? A plus B is equal to B plus A. You can use any variable, children, but it should be in the small form. That is, C plus D equal to D plus C. X plus Y equal to Y plus Z. Okay, you can use any alphabet which should be in the small form. Okay. Now, first we are going to find the A plus B. A plus B equal to 44. Here we are taking the value of A as 44 and B as minus 35. 44 plus minus 35, which is equal to 44 plus into minus minus 35. So the answer is 9. Next, we are going to find the B plus A. B plus A equal to, first you have to write the minus 35 first and then 44 next. That is minus 35, you in the bracket, minus 35 plus 44, as per the root 2 you get 9. Thus, we are, by observing the equation 1 and 2, what you have controlled? A plus B is equal to B plus A plus the commutative property is verified for the given integer 44 and minus 35. Dear children,
my dear children, in today's activity you are going to learn how to draw and measure the angles. Before that, let us see some mathematical instruments. Okay, now we are going to see what are the mathematical instrument inside the geometry box. Okay, so this is the geometry box. Now let us see what are the instrument inside it. Okay, this is pencil. See, you know this instrument as, yes, what is this? Scale. We can also call the scale as ruler. Okay, how do you call the scale as ruler? So this is a basic mathematical instrument. Next we are going to see this one. This is said to be divider. How do you call this? Divider. You will use this divider in your higher studies. Okay, so this is said to be divider. Next we are going to see compass. See here, this is said to be compass. Using this compass you can draw the circle. You can easily fix the pencil inside this compass and then you can tight this and then you may use this compass to draw the circle. Okay, so this is the compass. Next we are going to see protector. This is the instrument we are going to use in today's activity. What is this? This is protector. This is in the shape of semicircle. Okay, see here, this is protector. This is used to measure the angles and draw the angles. Next you are seeing set square. Okay, set means pair. Here you are seeing a pair of two triangles. They are called as set square. You will use this set square in your IS studies. Okay, what are the mathematical instruments? Ruler, protector, divider, compass and set square. Okay, so to draw the angle we have to use protector and scale only. No need of these instruments. So you buy only the protector and the scale. Okay, these two instruments are enough to draw the angles and measure the angles. Okay, now children, we are going to measure these angles. Okay, for to measure these angle we have to use protector. So using this protector only you can measure these angle. Okay, before measuring these angles let me know the measurement in the protector. See here, see here children, in this protector you have the measurement of degrees. See here, 0 degree, 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, 40, 50, 60 degree, 70 degree, 80 degree, 90 degree, 100 degree, 110 degree, 120 degree, 130 degree, 140 degree, 150 degree, 160, 170, 180 degree. Similarly, in the above two that also you have the one more representation of degrees. Okay, you have to use the below line, don't use the above line. Okay, you have to use this below line to measure the angles now. Okay, don't use the above line. Okay, see here, this is 0 degree. Between the 0 degree and 10 degree you have the 10 separate 10 partition lines. Okay, 0.5 means this one. Okay, 0.7 means this one. Similarly, between the each degree you have the 10 partition lines as in the ruler. Okay, as in the ruler, here also we have the partition lines. Okay, so you see here, this is the degree, represent 30 degree. You have to see the below line, don't see the upper line. Okay, so this line represent the degree 30, next to that 31 degree, next to that 32, 33, 34, this line represent 35 degree, next to that 36, 37, 38, 39, this one 40. So this is the way you have to use the protractor. Do you understand, children? Now we are going to measure this angle. For that you have to place the protractor like this. See here, children, this is called midpoint of the protractor. See here, this point is said to be midpoint of the protractor. This midpoint should coincide with this vertex of the angle. See here how I am placing this protractor. Listen carefully, children, then only you can easily understand this activity. See here, here you have to place this midpoint to this vertex. So you have to place the protractor like this. At the same time, this line, this line is said to be baseline. This baseline should coincide with this line. So see here how I am placing. See here, thus the baseline coincide with this line and the midpoint coincide with the vertex. Okay, see here how I am placing. Now we are going to measure the angle. See here, what is the angle? See here, this is 20 and this is 25, 26, 27. So 27 is the angle made by these two arms. So what is the angle? 27. So you have to write here as 27. Okay, how do you write the 30 angle? See here, suppose if the arm comes in this line, means you can write 30 degrees. So the measure of this angle is 27 degrees. Do you understand? Now we are going to measure this angle. So you have to place this midpoint of the protector at the vertex and the baseline should coincide with this arm. Okay, see here how I am placing the protector. This is the way you have to place the protector. So you must be careful, this line should be coincide with this arm. Okay, then only you can get the accurate measurement. See here how I am placing. It is very accurate. You have to place the protector like this. This baseline should coincide with this arm. Now we are going to measure the angle. So what is the measure of this angle? Yes, it is 90 degrees. It is a right angle. So here you have to write 90 degrees. For right angle only you have to use this symbol like this. Okay, for the remaining angles you have to use this arc like this. Okay, for 90 degree only you have to draw like this. This is the perpendicular symbol. Here you have to write 90 degrees. So measure of this angle is 90 degree angle. For that you have to place the protector. See here, this midpoint of the protector should coincide with this vertex of the angle. See here, and also this baseline should coincide with the arm of the angle. See here, this 0 degree must coincide with this arm. Then only you can get the accurate measurement. Next you have to measure the angle. See, what is the angle? Yes, it is 130 degrees. You have to observe the below line. Don't see the above line. See the below line. So the angle measures to 130 degrees. So here you have to write it as 130 degrees. Thus we have measured the angle. It is 130 degrees. Now children, we are going to draw the angle 30 degrees. How we are going to draw the angle? See here, for that you have to take the scale and you have to draw a line segment for some measurement. Now I am taking the measurement of 5 centimeters. This is not an compulsory, children, you may take any measurement. Thus I have extended that 5 centimeters. After that, now I am going to draw the angle 30 degrees. Okay, next you have to place the protector. The midpoint should be one end of that line segment. See here, so this is the way you have to place the protector and this 0 degree must coincide with this line segment. Okay, now we are going to draw the angle 30 degrees. So you have to count the degree from the below line. 0, 10, 20, 30. So here you have to mark it as dot. After that you have to use the scale and place the tip of the pencil here and place the scale like this. Adjust the scale. and then you have to draw the line segment and then put the arrow mark and then you have to write it as 30 degree. Thus we have drawn the angle 30 degree. Do you understand, children? Next, children, we are going to draw the angle 110 degree. Okay, again use the scale, draw a line segment, mark this point, put the arrow symbol here. Next, use the protractor. You have to put the arrow symbol very sharply. Okay, next you have to use, next use the protractor and place the protractor like this. The midpoint should coincide with the vertex and 0 degree with coincide with the line segment. After that, start to count the degree in the below line. Our measurement is 110 degree. See here, 80, 90, 100, 110 is here. Don't see the above line, see the below line. So this is the 110. So put the point here. After that, you have to make use of the scale and adjust the scale like this. And then draw a line segment to join the vertex and this point. Okay. Draw accurately, children. Okay. So make this angle as 110 degree. Thus we have drawn the angle 110 degree. Next we are going to draw the angle 35 degree. Okay. Again take the scale, draw a line segment, put the arrow mark, mark the point here, take the protractor, the midpoint should coincide with this point and the baseline should coincide with the 0 degree and start to count. Your measurement is 35 degree. So 0, 10, 20, 30, after the 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. This line represents 35. So near to this point, you have to put the dot. After that, make use of the scale, join the vertex and the marked point, extend the line. Name the angle as 35 degree. I hope you have understand how to measure the angles and how to draw the angles. It's clear, children? Thank you.